Brasseur and Eisler have never won this championship. They're the leaders after the technical program. But the sentimental favorites have to be Barb Underhill and Paul Martini. This is not their last performance, but it is their last competition in a career that began over 20 years ago. She was 14 and he was 16, and it wasn't instant success. It never is in this sport. In fact, their best achievements came as they matured.
I think we did okay as amateurs, won a world title, never won an Olympic medal, and yet as professionals, we've been at it for how many years now? Unfortunately, you know, the phone keeps ringing, so yeah. I think that says something about the quality of material that we've been doing as professionals.
So why have you decided then that this will be your final year?
Life has just gotten too busy. Number one, I think our families, we want to, you know, be there a little bit more for them. We don't have the time now with our careers in television and Paul's coaching. We don't have the time to get into the rink that it takes to keep our skating at a level where we want it. And I think we were able to do that this year, but we just can't do it much longer.
You just find that you lose the edge. I mean, as many years as we've been skating professionally, you know, lights, camera, action.
Right.
If you don't do it on a regular basis, you lose it. I mean, we'll take, you know, miss 3 or 4 weeks of not doing a show, and you're out of your comfort range. You're out of the comfort zone. I don't know where the rink is. I mean, I like to think, you know, you think it would be automatic, but it's really not. Mm-hmm. And it's one thing to go into a well-lit practice rink day in, day out, and you're working, but that's not the same environment as having to do it for real under lights and that.
Feel it's important to go out in the high?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah. We want to go out feeling really great about our skating. And that's the other reason, you know. We still feel really good about our skating. And I think we're still skating as well as we've ever skated.
I mean, no offense to the proto pop-offs, but I have no desire to emulate them, you know?
No one who's watched them will forget the halo of snow in Barb's hair after their death spiral. Or the trademark leap of faith. Or the romance they created on ice, though, as we always said, they're married, but not to each other.
Barb, I watch you get out on that ice to compete or to perform. As soon as the lights hit, that natural born performer comes out in you.
Mm-hmm.
How are you going to fill that void?
I have no idea. I don't think you can. I don't think we can fill it. It's something that we just have to sort of close the door on and take the memories with us and hold on to them, because I don't think there's anything that'll ever compare.
What memories will you hold closest?
Just the memory of the feeling of what it's like out there. You know, that feeling of complete freedom and complete joy. And I mean, I'm going to have to get out there on the ice and just skate. I know that, just for myself, not to perform or anything, because that feeling is just something that I'll always treasure.
As we will always treasure them. Here now in their final competitive performance, Barbara Underhill and Paul Martini, the music, Way Over Yonder, written by Carol King, sung by Blessed Union of Souls.
Way over yonder is the place that I know. Where I can find shelter.
This is a new program for Barb and Paul, and Barb was telling me earlier that this is one of her favorite programs that she's ever done. Choreographed by Lori Nickel, who choreographs for Michelle Kwan.
Triple sound. Wow, a little hitch on the takeoff. A little higher than the last one they did in the technical program. Couldn't control the landing as well.
Yeah.
they incorporate all their technical difficulty within the context of the choreography. Everything flows into the next thing. It's seamless. Everything just kind of melts into the next.
They skated with different partners in the 1976 Canadian Championships. Both independent of each other decided to make a change and got together for the first time in the summer of 77.
Hard to believe they're even considering retirement.
Their last event will be in Toronto on March 27th.
I'll be there for that one. They brought so much to this sport. The sport's going to miss them. I just hope... Is your daughter?
Barbara Underhill and Paul Martini.
I just hope nobody takes for granted the impact that they've had on professional pair skating and pair skating in general. Truly an amazing couple. They've given so much and had so much success over the years. They're going to be missed. Throw triple sack out. Looked like they got a little stuck right here in the takeoff. Didn't get it off soon enough. Big, high one. It's a little bit of a turn out there on the landing. Throw axle is just a monster. Look how much ice this covers. It just goes. She just throws her, and she's like fearless. Okay, I got this one. 1 foot, no problem. It's like jumping off the roof of your house. You know, you're going to land on 1 foot. Her husband and her daughter looking on, saying, yeah, Daddy, it's pretty good. Yeah.
Cross your fingers. Here's a move that these two invented. You've seen other skaters perform it, none as well as Barb and Paul. Look at how she flies. You know, these two have been together, as Vern said, since 1977. They never feel for each other. They just know one another's there.
And the first set of marks now for Underhill and Martini.
9.7, 9.8.
When you're trying to pull up, 9.7, 9.8 is not what you want to see on the scorecard. The one mistake probably cost him a tenth, but beautiful program.
The artistic mark.
9.8, 9.9, 9.8, 9.7, 9.8, and 9.8.
That was good.
Total scores, 97.9.
And the total, 97.9. Dad and daughter look on. And Underhill and Martini were tied with Kovajikova and Novotny after the technical program. Next on the ice, Radka Kovajikova, Renee Novotny. The music is called Time to Say Goodbye. It will be sung by Sarah Brighton.
Thank you.
triple toe loop. Nice save on that, a little over rotated. Side by side, double toe loops. It's really rare that you see a pairs program choreographed by ice dancers. This program was choreographed by Klimova and Ponomarenko, Olympic champions from 1992. Just when you get mesmerized by a program and the flawless footwork, they remind you that it's still skating and it's still difficult.
Novotny. The defending champions, Elena Betsky and Denis Petrov, had to withdraw from the event because of Elena's injury, a groin injury, so only three pairs competing here in the Canadian Pros.
Look at the released element in this program, a throw triple toe loop. Watch how strong she is to save this. It's a little over-rotated. She had to come down on 2 feet, but when you're over-rotating and your hip is open, and you just know it's... You know it's skating. You know it's difficult. It's meant to look easy. Once you think it's easy, they remind you that it's not. A little tangle on the feet there.
Here's a look at an interesting variation on a death spiral. She was so expressive in this program. I really enjoyed it. Tough to hold your edge on that one.
Now the technical marks for Radka
Kovalenkova and Renee Novotny. Keep in mind, they were tied with Underhill and Martinez.
9.7.
Program was beautifully skated. Strength was in the choreography, not so much the technical aspects of it. Really one big release move and some nice lifts.
9.8.
It's important as pair skaters more than any other event to really find your niche and how you belong in the sport with the other skaters. And they're on their way. They're really improving every year.
Total here in Canada in the second program of 97 points. And that puts them in second place for the moment behind Underhill and Martini.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, Isabel Rasur and Lloyd Eisler.
Kurt Browning and his wife Sonia look on. Kurt will skate later. He's the leader in the men's, and now the leaders in the pairs. Rasur and Eisler, as in Isabel and Lloyd. And the music from Kool and the Gang, it's called Celebration.
Now, if you're familiar with Rasur and Eisler skating, you know they love to do characterizations. They love to do pieces that have a lot of personality. And, you know, Herb tends to be a little shameless at times. Did it once. Want to see it again? Just in case you guys missed it. There it is again. Fly high and say bye.
We gon' celebrate your party with you. Come on now.
One-handed Detroiter.
Celebrate and have a good time.
and to trust her partner for that drop.
It's called a chainsaw.
Hold on to your hair, Herb.
Hope the clue is good. Paul backstage look on, and there comes the there comes the wig.
He was wearing a wig.
Isabel Rasur and Lloyd Eisler.
Scott talked about the importance for a pair team to find their niche, and these two certainly have.
Well, we'll see if they're also champions. Back with our assistant director as Brasseur and Eisler wait for their marks.
Here's a look at the lift they did from the Olympic program. The woman in this lift has to keep all of her muscles tight to control it. She has to twist against the position to hold it. And then, as Vern said, boy, she's got to trust her partner here.
Get my feet a little sore.
My least favorite move in all of skating.
Thanks, girls.
I cringe every time I see this, because if his hands come off her boot, she is planted into the ice head first. Just so dangerous. But they do it so well. They do it a little faster and a little higher than the other pairs. And again, she's totally fearless, and he's so strong. It's just amazing to watch.
And the first set of marks now for Lloyd and Isabel.
Is she up again?
They're shooting for 97.5. That will give them the championship.
What we all must remember is that those seven judges are actually extensions of the audience in many cases. And if you hit the stands like they did, if you get the people on their feet, you're going to get those judges to push some pretty high numbers on those keypads.
The artistic mark.
Artistic mark.
9.9.
This is the one you can't predict when you're out there doing Cool the Gang with bell bottoms and a wig. You're not really sure if they're going to go 9.9 or where they're going to go with it.
9.9.
Great performance, strong marks, easily gives the championship.
9.8.
The total for Isabel Brasseur and Lloyd Eisler, 98.4. Jose Picard, the coach, looks on. And Lloyd and Isabel have won the championship here in Kitchener. They do so easily over Barbara Underhill and Paul Martini. Kovajikova and Novotny finished
third. We'd like
you
to stay with us for that.
And let's go down to Tracy Wilson.
Well, congratulations to both of you. This is your fourth time here. You've been second three times. How does it feel to finally win it?
It feels nice, but I think the main thing, you know, it's that people enjoyed what we did, and we enjoy what we did. And it's funny to say, every other time we skated perfect when we were here. This year we had a little slight mistake and we finished first. But obviously, you know, the rest of our program was apparently okay. And like Lloyd said earlier, you know, all the team are good, and it's always nice to compete here. And I think it's a bonus to be first.
And a bonus to be skating in front of so many friends and in a place you trained for so many years.
Yeah, it's nice to come back home and do so well. I think that after leaving, and you forget what it was actually like, all the hard years that obviously brought you to this point. And it was nice to have my family and, of course, Mr. Leach there watching too, and just to have everyone home. And I hear all the kids up from Preston up in the far corner, so that makes me feel good.
Where did you learn those moves?
We learned a lot of them from Cirque du Soleil and also from watching the videos that we do for rock and roll. And
a little John Travolta?
Well, you know, I watch a little video every now and then, and Isabel helps me. But
congratulations to you both. Thanks.
Who's the best skater out there?
Mama.
Second place to Barb Underhill, whose daughter was obviously not a judge.
Yeah, she said, who's your first favorite?
Mama.
Who's your second favorite?
Paul.
Who's your third favorite?
Yuka.
Yuka. Yuka. Who's your fourth favorite?
No. I don't have a fourth favorite.
I thought Jose. What about Jose?
Oh, silly me.
Jose?
But they left us with another golden memory.
Way over yonder.
Paul and Barb, your final competition in Canada after so many years, you must have mixed emotions.
Well, I must say that I didn't have them while I was skating. If you let those kinds of thoughts get into your head and race around, you're not going to do a very good skate. But now that it's over, it's an event that I never really came into it thinking this is the very end. And I don't even find myself thinking about that yet. It's just another skate, another show, another event, do my best.
I'm glad, personally.
Tired of competing?
I'm tired of it.
I don't like it at all. I've had enough of that. I still love to perform, and I think we're enjoying skating more now than ever. But I'll give this part up any day. I can't take it anymore.
Amazing indeed. Artistic programs coming up. They'll skate in the reverse order of these standings, which have Karen Kadavy barely in first over her chief rival this season, José Chouinard. And now the first to skate the artistic program in fifth place and still bothered by that stress fracture in her left foot she picked up before the ladies' pro competition in Boise. Here is Liz Manley. The music, Leanne Rimes, Cowboy Sweetheart.
The jump that gave her the biggest problem in the technical program is coming around triple sow cow. Another one, she just didn't get up over the right leg, she had to double it. Axel. You ever get the chance to spend any time around Liz, this is kind of her personality. It's nonstop, go, 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 energetic, and never avoiding eye contact whenever possible.
You mentioned that it's important to let the jump happen and not try to make it happen. And Liz said because of the stress fracture, she's thinking about every jump.
Well, you're focusing on everything, and a nice double X there. But anytime you try to force something, you're making it so much more difficult. Skating is timing, and you need strength to pull these jumps off, but you've got to let them happen. You've got to trust your body to do the job that it's trained to do. And when you start thinking things, you're in trouble.
Thank you.
see very often is change foot scratch spins.
Liz Manley, the last Canadian woman to medal at the Olympics. And that won't change this year as Canada failed to qualify a woman for a place in the Olympic field.
Elizabeth Manley.
The idea in the rotation for a triple sow cow is to get up right over your right side and rotate over your right side. Now watch, she'll throw her right leg up in the air and she can't get over it. It's just away from her. She needs to be right, putting all of her balance right over that. She couldn't do that, and that's the reason it was a double sow cow. A lot of speed coming in here, some choreography right into this double axel. She'll step right up, and you can see she gets right up over her right side right there and lands on that right foot. So important for rotation jumps.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, technical marks. Yeah, the first set of marks for
9.6.
Technical merit.
9.7.
The high and low thrown out. 9.6 is 9.7. First skater in this portion of the competition. Those aren't all bad.
9.6 and 9.7.
And in contrast to the technical program, the weight in favor of the artistic mark, 60%, which is the mark you're seeing now.
9.7, 9.7, 9.7, 9.7, and 9.7. The total score is 96.
The total for Liz Manley, 96.8. Rosalind Sumner's is next.
Now I can relax.
Ladies and gentlemen, Rosalind Sumner's.
Welcome back to Kitchener, Ontario, and on the ice currently in fourth place. Here is Rosalind Sumner's The Music Mouth, performed by Meryl Bainbridge.
Thank you.
Kelly Sumners, who again this winter is touring with Scott on the Stars on Ice Tour.
Roslyn Sumners!
And with Kurt Browning, who is leading the men's event. Roz expressed her feelings about the rigors of travel. She came to the arena tonight wearing a t-shirt on the back that said, day off, travel day, same thing, whatever.
Perfect double axel, same thing, whatever. She loves that jump, and it loves her back. It's her most difficult jump. A lot of steps, a lot of choreography in this. Again, a different look for Roslyn, brand new, but you can see how she works the feet. She's going from edge, forward, backward, toe work, double toe loop here.
And now, the technical marks for Roslyn Sumners.
Nice.
9.6.
And here are the marks for Roslyn Sumners.
9.6.
Good marks. It could be a little bit higher. Liz went for the triple and didn't do it. You got to compare it to Liz Manley, but the second mark should go way up. I think the judges are really going to like this program.
The artistic marks.
Well, let's see.
9.6, 9.8, 9.8, 9.6, 9.8, 9.6.
And I think all in all, Roz Sumners is quite pleased. You're welcome. Total for Roz of 96.8, and the total through the artistic program of 193, so that puts her ahead of Liz Manley and leads us onto the ice.
Gentlemen, Yuka Sato.
For the lady currently in third place. Here is Yuka Sato. The music, That Girl, performed by Maxie Priest.
Still able to do it.
Still got the bright smile. She is really fighting through this period. Her mom, Kamiko, who is also her coach.
Yukira Sato.
Saw her, Scott, before the artistic program. And she's a little disheartened because of the problems she's having with the jumps.
She has so many skills, so many abilities, talents. There's no weakness to her skating, but right now, the jumps have just left. We talk about the jumps a lot, but look at this footwork. It's great. It's inventive. She's using her whole body, upper, lower, a lot of edges, twisting, turning, keeping the speed going. It's floating across the ice. Triple sash. She just saved this. Watch on the way down. She looks like she goes after it. She really gets aggressive here. Now watch right. Whoa! Right there.
And the first set of marks now for Yuka Sato.
9.7. 9.8.
A little disparity here. You can see 9.6. I bet that's judging Yuka against what judge number 6 knows she can do in the 9.8 for the height, the heart, and the fight of going for that triple Sackow and pulling it off.
And the artistic mark, again, 60% of this score.
9.6.
High and lower thrown out, and the total for Yuka Sato of 97.2 keeps her in front of Roz Sumners and Elizabeth Manley. Jose Chouinard and Karen Kadavy coming up. They are separated by 0.1 of a point. There may be few pictures as pretty as Jose Chouinard on a snowy morning, with a chance to talk about a career that only now seems to be finding its focus. As an amateur, she was 3 times the Canadian national champion. 2 went to the Olympics. And 2 finished 9th.
The amateur was, I don't know, like, I think I have, like, I'm a little upset about it still. It was tough. I think it was destroying me more than it was giving me something positive. And it's all turning around right now. Like, it's all becoming positive, and I'm skating the way I was skating, the way I knew myself when I was on the ice, and it's the best feeling. I'm just sorry that it wasn't there on time and went at the end of my career, so.
On the night that Tanya Harding broke a lace and left the ice, Jose Chouinard was a skater who had to change her routine and skate her program before she was ready.
The first thing I thought is like running through the ice. And I heard Lois saying, walk! Like yelling, I mean, just walk. And then all around it went so fast. Like the team leader was saying, like, no, she doesn't have to go right now. No, she doesn't have to go. And meanwhile, like, I feel the people like clapping, like wanting something to happen. It's just, you know, it's the biggest moment of your life. You train all your life for this, and all of a sudden everything goes so fast around you. It's like you're in a dream. You know how like you move slowly, you feel like you move slowly, but everything else around like moves really fast. And that's a little bit like it felt.
Her free skate did not go the way she dreamed it would. And though she rallied and finished with strength, this was not the memory it might have been.
I never really believed in my talent. I think I was better than what I thought, and I never really believed it. And that was and handicap for me, I think. It was just not believing enough, and I always looked at the other ones, and I always thought they were better than me. And then every time I just went out there and compete against myself, I was better.
How is it for you now?
Life is different.
How so?
Well, I think I realized there are other things in life than skating. You know, there's
A husband.
Brand new husband.
She married pair skater Jean-Michel Bombardier last August. Before that, there was 1 final try in the amateur ranks. It ended badly as she failed to even qualify at Canadian Nationals for the world team.
When that happened at Nationals, they say, you know, there's things even bigger than this, Jose. Like, this isn't, like, all, like, skating. You know, you'll have a child, and this is going to be the biggest moment of your life. And I said, I couldn't believe it at the time they were saying it. And I'm like, no, today this is the worst thing. Like, I feel like I lost everything, like, all the effort and everything. And then now, no, it's not true.
there's so much other stuff in life that, you know, will bring you more joy.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, Josie,
she has clearly been finding some of that joy on the ice in her professional career, skating with a consistency we never saw in her amateur days. Now in second place, but only a tenth of a point behind Karen Kadavy, Josie Chouinard, skating a delightful new number called The Sweater.
Girl, I know you will understand this and feel the intrinsic and incredible emotion. You have just pulled over your head the worn, warm sweater belonging to a boy. That slightly goat-like smell which all teenage boys possess, and that smell will lovingly transfer to all your other clothes.
Triple X, little turnout.
Now, if the sweater has, like, reindeer on it or a funny color like yellow, I'm sorry, you can't get away with a sweater like that. Look for brown or gray or blue. Anything other than that, and you know you're dealing with someone who's different. And difference is not what you're looking for. You're looking for the boy of your dreams, who is the same boy in the dreams of all of your friends. Now, the sweater isn't going to fit you, of course. You have to kind of roll up the sleeves in a jaunty way that says, this is the sweater belonging to a boy, and the boy is a genuine hunk, a hunk of burn and love, and this is not just some hand-me-down from your brother or your father. Monday, wear the sweater to school. Be calm, look cute. Don't tell him a dream ahead about the place the two of you would share and get over. Just be yourself. The best, cutest, quietest version of yourself.
The sweater.
He looks at you, and he looks away, and then he walks away, and the smell of the sweater hits you again, suddenly like ape scent gloriola, and you get a note passed to you by a girl in history that says he needs his sweater back. He forgot that you put it on in the tent on Saturday, and he's been looking for it. And you don't have to die of humiliation. You are a strong person, and this is a learning experience. You can still hold your head up high as you run from the classroom tearing the stinking sweater from your body. You look at that sweater carefully, and you realize that love made you temporarily blind. You got a secret now, honey, and though you would never sink as low as him, you could blab it all over the school if you wanted. The label in that sweater said 100%.
Leanne Miller on the right, she choreographed the piece. Rosalind Sumners showing her appreciation. And Josie Chouinard.
Josie Chouinard.
Now, you know me, I'm not one for gimmicks or anything like that.
No.
No, not at all. I love that number. I just think it's so much fun. She acts throughout. She sprinkles like the hardest of technical difficulties. She keeps the focus and the energy up throughout. What a great piece. I just love that. It's going to be hugely popular up here when she tours in the spring. Now, you've got the hardest jump in your program, and you're wearing a costume. Well, part of your costume is like 12 sizes too big, and you're doing a triple Lutz. Now, your hands are buried in the sleeves. You reach back, and this thing's going to fly all over the place, and you almost land it perfectly. A little turnout in the end, but you can tell she's happy with that. And as the program developed, you could see she was growing in confidence. Look at look on her face right there, knowing that she's going into a triple toe loop, and she just goes right after it. Look at the height, the distance, the air position, swish.
Oh my God.
Choreographer and the competitor looking on saying, okay, okay, oh, this is really, see, oh, look, right here, come on, come on, all right. This is so exciting. Isn't this fun? That's what we work so hard for.
And we now see to what degree the judges reward Jose Chouinard.
9.7. 9.9.
These are very good marks.
9.8. 9.9. 9.8. 9.8. 9.8.
The next set will tell the tale. Sometimes these judges get a little conservative.
Now the artistic marks. 9.8, 9.9, 9.7, 9.8, 9.8, 9.8.
So after the high and low are thrown out, it's 9.8s across the board. The total of 98 for Jose Chouinard. She has a sizable lead over Yuka Sato, Roz Sumners, and Liz Manley. And she gets Karen Kadavy something at which to shoot. Here's the defending champion. She won this event in Ottawa a year ago. She comes into her artistic program having had a lead of 0.1. Here's Karen Kadavy, the music performed by Jewel.
Performances, preparation was everything to win the competition over a very strong field that included Jose Chouinard.
competition should still be close, but one jump can make all the difference in the world. Three minutes of beautiful skating, 1 second of error. Such a shame.
From Erie, Pennsylvania, the defending champion with the bobble and the triple toe loop,
Karen Kinney.
Will it cost her the title? Will Jose Chouinard win this championship? We'll get the marks when we return to Kitchener, Ontario, after these messages.
Hey, Brett. Love you.
Karen Kadavy saying hi to her husband, Dr. Brett Johnson, as she awaits her scores.
She fought for this. The hardest jump in the program, triple loop. You take off and land on the right foot. Three revolutions. One, two, three. A little tilted, a little short of revolution, but she was so beautifully over her right side. She saved a triple toe. Little difference right here. It slips out from under her. Can't hang on. When you're a competitor in this event, you want your competitors to skate the best they can, and you just, oh, you feel every single step.
And now the judgment of the officials. Really, Karen knows that this is not going to be good news. We'll see.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the technical marks for Karen Kadavy. 9.6, 9.7. 9.8.
You have to wonder if she stood up 9. On the triple toe 7. Loop. Tenth, 9. Two tenths 8. From each judge.
9.7.
At least a tenth.
And 9.6.
Yeah.
The artistic
and the artistic mark.
9.8. 9.7.
Anytime you 9. Fall, 9. You mar the flow 9. Of the routine, and that can come off the second 9. Mark as well. 9. Unfortunate, Eric. Such a beautiful 9. Program, 7. But one slip.
9.8. The total score is 97.
The total for 7. Karen Kadavy, 97.7. But Jose Chouinard wins the championship by 0.2. But Jose Chouinard wins the championship by 0.2. Karen Kadavy congratulating Jose. The difference, Scott, was one jump.
The triple toe loop, Karen's was at the end of the program, maybe a little tired. Jose, big, tight, 1 foot in that huge sweater. How did she jump in that sweater? Wow.
And now let's go to Tracy Wilson.
Jose, your thoughts on how you're feeling right now?
Oh, well, it's hard to say. My stomach's going like this in the inside, and I just love the crowd. I love this number. I just want to do it over and over. And like I told you before, I think I was thinking too much for tonight, yesterday, last night. So I think I was just anxious to do it. And I felt good out there. The crowd loved it, and I just got more into it as the number went on. And now I think I'm more nervous now than I was before. So
feel good to win at home?
Very good. I just couldn't. I was really waiting for this moment, so it felt good. It's been a long time, but I had a good year and it's a good ending, so
congratulations.
Thank you. Oh, wow.
She won the first Canadian Pro back in the fall of 1994. Now she has won the latest. Jose Chouinard beats the defending champion by only 0.2 of a point. Yuka Sato finishes third, Roz Sumner's fourth, and Elizabeth Manley in fifth. There's Jose's husband, Jean-Michel Bombardier, being pulled onto the CTV set for a kiss.
Please, I didn't want to do this.
A bit reluctantly. Andrew Lundquist along with Scott Hamilton and Kurt Browning with a sizable lead. As a matter of fact, the last time Kurt did not win this event, this guy took it.
Well, you notice I'm not competing anymore in this event. Kurt is so strong. He combines so many qualities. He's a brilliant jumper. His choreography is phenomenal. He's charting new territory every time he selects a piece of music. And really, there's nobody in this competition that can touch him. Brian Orser is skating very well. But Kurt Browning, brilliant. And he gets better every single year.
my first world championship that I won, 1989, and Munich, for example, 1991, like, I was very, very cocky. I really enjoyed the competition. The more the competition, the better I skated as an amateur. And as a professional, I don't quite feel that same way. I'm more competing against myself. I want to try and be a little better than I was last year. Whereas when I was an amateur, I just wanted, you know, to be the biggest triple axel you've ever seen, or the first to do the quad. And I was addicted to this jumping frenzy. I had the Olympic gold medal. I was closest to the Olympic gold medal in the parking lot of the Olympic Village when I found out that Victor and Brian hadn't skated to their best at the short program, and I was last skater. I was set up. I skate down the ice, I do triple axel double toe, and I had the Olympic gold medal. But I didn't have my first world championship until I went and took it. I didn't have my second one. I didn't have my third one. I didn't have my fourth. I didn't have any of those things. I didn't have the first quad. I wasn't in the Guinness. I didn't have all those things till I made them happen. And you know what? I didn't make an Olympic medal happen. But I wouldn't trade that for any of the things that I did do. And I think I sit better with what happened in my career, the bad stuff, than a lot of other athletes do, because I'm okay with it. I really am. It bugs me sometimes. I'm not lying. You never know when it's going to hit you. Every once in a while, you look at someone and you go, oh, why did I do that? And then it goes away. I would say that certainly getting married changes who you are. And it did with me. And she doesn't seem to allow me any excuses. I come home, you know, I skated like crap today. And she goes, why? Well, my skates didn't feel good. She goes, doesn't matter. You have to skate good every day. And I go, me, you don't understand. You're not a skater. You can't skate good every day. And she goes, yes, you can. I dance good every day. You have to skate good every day. So it changed, you know, where was she when I was 16? Eh? But, yeah, she is a wonderful inspiration. I like where I am now better. I like the full program. I like trying to pull stuff out of people. I want to make people smile. And I want to do big jumps too, but my priorities have shifted. The greatest thing about skating is finding something, you know, just a little bit more. And I think that the more I work, you know, I'm the more curious I am about what I'm going to do next. And it's a little bit less about, you know, whether or not I'm world professional champion, a little bit more about am I better than I was last year. And I hope I can keep that up for a couple more years.
He'll be the last to skate in this championship. The men skate in reverse order of their standings in the technical program. Now Joseph Sobotnik is pulled out of the competition due to a sinus infection. He had so much trouble in his technical program. So the first on the ice is the inimitable Gary Beacom. And Gary will skate to the music of Bruce Cockburn.
Heart and soul. Triple flip, hangs on to that.
Some people get the shine.
Gary said he felt a measure of redemption after the technical program here. In 1980, qualifying for the Olympic team for Canada, he had the lead in this building after the short program and fell apart in the long and did not make it to Lake Placid. He did get to Sarajevo in 84 as a Canadian Olympic team member.
Such a difficult entrance to that double axel. Now for his technical program, he wore brown suede skates. And you can tell this is the artistic because he's wearing purple suede skates. He doesn't do anything by the book. He has one of those bikes where you sit on the handlebars and you pedal kind of upside down. And he skis without poles. You get on a golf course with him, he's the only guy I've ever played with who plays by the rules. No mulligans for Gary Beacom.
The normal ending to a program either.
You've just spent 3 minutes plus in Garyland, and Kurt watched the whole thing.
Gary Beacom.
This is a great jump sequence, right? Watch this combination. He does a 1.5 flip right here, right? Then he goes into another 1.5 flip. You think he's going to do double? Then he comes out forward into a double toe loop, but 1.5 toe loop. Then he goes another 1.5 toe loop into a double flip. When you're a skater, you watch Gary and you go, yeah. And where's he going with this? Cool. This is balance. You know, when you're spinning and you're thinking you're going to stay over the edge, try to center the spin, try to get it to go with some speed, right? You're going to get it cranked up. Nope. Gary puts his leg over here, crosses it, twists, and look at the control. That skate's going forward. That is so difficult. Any skater in the world right now is going, How does he do that? Well, he's the only one that does.
Gary has made his way to Kiss and Cry, where we'll give him the chance to comment on his own skating.
Yay. Bravo. The purple skates rule.
And for the skates alone.
That was a little scruffy, but what the heck? I don't think it's a deduction on that, is it?
2 hours? I don't think so.
Oh boy, is that a spooky shot. Channeling. The judges asked me to do this combination, so I did it just for them. Because I'm a nice dude. Hopefully they're going to be nice back.
Well, now let's see if they're nice back.
Now the technical marks for Gary Beacom. 9.8. 9.8. 9.7.
seven signs. Now those are pretty good marks for a rebel. You know, if you're going up against the grain, these are judges.
9.7.
And the artistic mark.
The artistic marks. 9.9. 9.8. 9.9.
They're strong. These judges are skaters and coaches, and they know the difficulty, a lot of the stuff that he does. Innovative, inventive.
9.8.
Strange.
97.9.
Total for Gary Beacom, 97.9. Next on the ice, currently in third place, and competing in Canada for the first time since his magical season of 1996 when he took bronze in the World Championships in Edmonton. Here is Rudy Galindo. The music, Send in the Clowns, performed by Judy Collins.
For Rudy. He loves to experiment, try new things. He has some outrageous programs.
great stuff. His sister and coach, Laura Galindo. And a full house at Kitchener Municipal Auditorium.
Rudy Galindo.
There's a warmth that exists between Rudy Galindo and the skating audience. It's hard to describe, but it's genuine, and it's fun to watch. He's unique to the rest of the skating world. And again, I think the professional world's going to be a very friendly place for him. He's going to be able to explore a lot of different things. Now, anytime you use a gimmick or any kind of prop, you know it's going to blow up in your face. I saw him practice this morning a half a dozen times, and every single time it worked. It was great. I'm going, okay, I'm waiting for something to happen now. And oh, perfect. Every single time he goes right back to it. It's always tougher on the coach, especially when you're related to them. You know, they're wanting every step to be just right. Okay, we worked on that. Good stuff.
And now the marks for Rudy Galindo.
The marks for Rudy Galindo. 9.8.
Great marks.
9.8.
9.8. 9.7.
And 9.8.
Kurt Browning and the ladies champion, José Chouinard.
9.8.
Kurt coming up. Here are the second set of marks.
9.9 to 9.6. One loved it, another one didn't.
9.8. 9.8. 9.6.
Now the total for Rudy Galindo of 98.1 puts him comfortably in front of Gary Beacom. When we
now, ladies and gentlemen, Brian
welcome back to Municipal Auditorium in Kitchener, Ontario, about an hour west of Toronto, and on the ice currently in second place, twice an Olympic silver medalist, here is Brian Orser and the music of Neil Diamond.
Stay with me here. Share with me, care with me,
this program. He normally skates it perfectly. Triple toe loop more than made up for it. Sometimes it's not about nine nines. It's not about what step you are on the podium or even what anyone else thinks. Sometimes it's from the heart and it's completely yours. And that performance is for Brian and his family. Double axel, he just goes right after. It's a great jump for him. He has a nice triple still. Seen him do it in practice. Jose. Brian is so popular. Everybody loves him so much. You know. Everyone feels. Triple toe loop. A little tilted there, but he's so strong right now. He's really worked hard to get his skating back.
And the first set for Brian Orser.
9.8.
Oh,
9.7.
It's a good mark.
That's better.
9.6.
That's better.
He's concentrating on that single sow cow, but again, when you look at the strength of performance, it's easy to ignore 1 second of a complete work like that. The next mark will go way up.
And this is the artistic program.
9.9. 9.9.
He should believe in this program on this regard from the marks because he believes in it when he's on the ice. He can see it, he can feel it.
9.9. And 9.9.
The total for Brian Orser of 98.4. And that puts him comfortably in front of Rudy Galindo and Gary Beacom. And now the ice belongs to Kurt Browning. Again, his wife, Sonia, watching from our commentary position as Kurt Browning skates to the music of Elvis Presley.
Every mannerism, confidence, so prepared, relatively new program.
Do you gaze at your doorstep and picture me there? Is your heart still clean? Shall I come?
Beautiful triple loop.
I wonder if he wants to.
Great camel spin here.
You know, someone says that the world is safe. They had me playing along.
Work here. Nobody does stuff like that.
You read your lines so stubbornly and never missed a cue. Then came act. Using the chain, you lacked strength. And why I'm not home.
Next jump.
Honey, you lied.
Great variation on an axel there.
And I
it's really tough to judge because you're so high in the air, then you have to pop your legs out.
But I really go on hearing your lines. And they go on living without you.
Triple sow, gorgeous.
Now the stage is bare. I'm going to stand there with emptiness all around. And if you won't come back again, then they can break. Is your heart still with me? Shall I come back?
Triple tone, no problem.
Tell me, dear, are you lonesome to love?
And that glance is toward his wife, Sonia Rodriguez. Kurt Browning.
What a great partnership Sonia and Kurt have established.
Kurt Browning.
Since their marriage, he is skating better than he's ever skated, and she's now a principal dancer with the National Guard of Canada. So it's worked for both of them. It's great. You know, I just want one time just to look at Kurt and say, oh, that could be better. I can't do that. I'll keep working on it, though. Variation on a single axle. And this is really hard to do. You get up in the air, you pull in tight, then you go pop, and you gotta get out, boom.
Awesome.
And then you have to land with flow and control in a nice position. And when you jump as big as Kurt, as is evident with this triple sow cow, it's like one, two, three, and swish, no problem. Nothing but net on that one. Brian Erson's like, yeah, he's great, he's good. It's tough, strong. Oh man, it's good stuff.
Now, ladies and gentlemen,
and now the marks
for Kurt Browning. 9.9. 9.9.
10.
10 and the 9.8 get thrown out. 9.9s across the board.
Artistic
and
mark.
The artistic mark.
9.9. 9.9.
10.
9.9.
9.9.
9.8. And 9.9.
A reprise. The 10 and the 9.8 get thrown out. The total for Kurt Browning, 99 points in the artistic program. And Kurt Browning successfully defends his championship. His score of 197.5. Ryan Orser winds up second. Rudy Galindo is third. And Gary Beacom fourth. Joseph Sobocek forced to withdraw because of illness. Right now, let's go down to Tracy Wilson.
Kurt, you made it look easy, but you came off the ice just telling me that you really had to work for it tonight.
Yeah, sometimes you step on a blade and you're just going, whoa, 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 and it maybe doesn't show, but you're feeling like there's too much outside edge. I had a bobble right off the top on what's supposed to be a very romantic moment on your knee, and I'm almost falling. So I had to recapture and regroup. Had a terrible triple loop warm-up. Took me four tries to do one. So I was looking up at Scott Hamilton, knowing that if I didn't do this triple loop, I was going to hear about it for the next 3 months. I was just happy about another good competition.
You have been skating so well lately, and many people feel that you're taking skating to a new level and that really you're becoming one of the all-time greats. How does that make you feel?
Well, taking skating to a new level, I don't know about that, but I do agree with you. I'm having more fun than I've ever had in this sport. I'm really looking forward to the next couple of years. I'm looking forward to being in the Stars Nice show and to see where it goes and to see what I can do with it. You know, I use kind of Scott as a mentor, and I just
I just think that a career should be something you enjoy. This is such a wonderful opportunity to entertain and to share and to have such a nice lifestyle and so many good friends. So, yeah, I'm going to try and learn from the last couple of years. You know, there's been some ups and some downs, and I want to enjoy this.
Congratulations. Only skater to receive perfect 10s in this competition. Well deserved.
Oh, thanks.
Okay.
We're back with an Olympic update right after this.